This video is just a quick demonstration of how to deal with improper integrals in wxMaxima. So for example, we can look at the integral of 1 over x squared from 1 to infinity. And in Maxima, inf is the symbol for infinity. And I hit shift enter, and I get my answer of 1. Let's look at what happens if we deal with a function that's actually divergent at infinity. So the antiderivative of 1 over x would give me natural log x, and as x goes to infinity, that blows up to infinity. Let's see what Maxima says. So it throws an error and says the integral is divergent. More specifically, we know the answer is positive infinity, and the way to get Maxima to agree with that is to think about how we would compute the integral. So you guess the antiderivative, that's the natural log function, and then in the upper limit of that integral, we have to take the limit as the argument goes to infinity. The symbol for natural log in Maxima is log, and so we want to take the limit of the natural log function as x goes to infinity. We hit shift enter, and Maxima tells us, oh yeah, that's positive infinity. That's why the integral was divergent. Next, we can look at an integral that involves a vertical asymptote, and I'm going to choose one that comes out to a finite area here. So I'm going to take the integral of 1 over square root x as x goes from 0 to 1. Now the problematic point there is x equals 0 because this function blows up to infinity when x approaches 0 from the right. But this integral results in a finite area, so let's see what happens. It turns out the area is 2. If we try the same thing with a function that blows up at x equals 0 but doesn't contain finite area, Maxima is going to tell us that integral diverges. In other words, it becomes infinite. So if we want to get a better answer than just that this thing is divergent, if we want to understand is it plus infinity or minus infinity, we have to think about how the integral is computed. And that would be to take the antiderivative of 1 over x, which is just log x, and then we evaluate it across the endpoints. Well, in our upper limit there, we would have log of 1. That's the right end of the integration interval, and that's just 0. And then we would subtract the log of 0. But that's a problematic point because the log of 0 is undefined. So we phrase that as a limit. I go limit log of x as x goes to 0 from the right. And you type out plus for that. Hit shift enter. And Maxima tells me negative negative infinity, which means positive infinity. The area contained under this curve is positive and infinite.